In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the Softr and Google Sheet permissions. Being able to create a web application in Softr that is empowered by data in Google Sheets, but where we give our users different levels of permissions based on their role or responsibility within the application. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be taking a look at user permissions inside of the web application builder Softr, a no-code tool that will allow you to build a front-end application driven or built upon data that can live in Airtable, Smart Suite, or Google Sheets. So in this video, we're going to be talking about how you can cultivate a different experience for your users depending upon their permission level in the application. But before I get into all of that, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you are new to the world of no code, you are going to be blown away by automation potential. And we have a training set up for you that will teach you the fundamentals of automation. You can grab that at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Wherever you found this video, be sure to look for that link and you can get signed up for free right there. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video and take a look at building the permissions inside of Softr and Google Sheets. Now, first, we're going to start off inside of Softr. If you don't already have an account in Softr and you want to follow along, be sure to use our link around this video and you can get set up with a free trial inside of Softr. But we're going to go into our templates right here and create a team wiki. And this we're going to do just to save some time. So I'm going to use this template and I'm actually going to tell it that I want to use our Google Sheets connection. And that is going to allow us to build the back end of this particular template in Google Sheets. Now, this isn't currently available in all of the Softr templates, but it is for this particular team wiki. That's why I'm using it for our example here. So now I want to go to that application. We've just created this new web application, as you saw, with just the push of a few buttons, which is amazing in and of its own right. And here we have our web application builder, and we can make any changes we want to here by adding blocks, editing blocks, etc. Now, if we flip into Google Sheets, we're also going to see that we have a new Google Sheet. Here it's been created for us called Copy of Team Wiki by Softr. And I can flip on into this and it will open up. And we see that we have four different key sheets that are driving our application. We have an employee directory, we have news, we have team resources, and we have feedback. And the data that lives on each of these sheets, again, this sheet was created for us by Softr, but the data that lives here is driving what's showing up in our web application. Now, for our example here today, because we are looking at the user permissions, what we care most about is how are we deriving our user experience? Who or what sheet in Google Sheets is cultivating that user experience? So in order to really dive into this, we should go back into Softr, and on the left-hand side of our screen, we can go to Users. And this is going to show us a list of all of the different users in our application. So these are the folks who, again, we have inside of that Google Sheet. So if we were to take a look here, we've got Kai and Tenzin. If we flip into Google Sheets, we're going to see those same names here. Here's Tenzin, here's Kai. So as you see, we have a one-to-one relationship. Anybody who has access in our users from Softr, it's because their name or their information lives here inside of our Google Sheet. Now, back inside of Softr, we can also see, if we're at all curious about how this is set up with our data source, this is going to tell us right here, this is connected to the employee directory. And so again, if we go back to our sheet, employee directory is the name of the particular sheet that we are looking at. Of course, we know that the overall sheet is called Copy of Team Wiki by Softr, but if we need to get a little bit more explanation as to what exact sheet within our solution is the one that holds the employee data, that is how we find that information out. So again, this right here is telling us where to look inside of Google Sheets to find that information. Now, what we care about here is how do we cultivate a different experience for our users depending on their roles or responsibilities inside of the organization? So in order to understand this better, we can flip over to user groups inside of the users component. So if we go into user groups, we see that we have two different user groups that have been built for this particular template. Now, I want to stress for you that if you're not starting from a template, but if you are instead starting from scratch, you can just add these groups yourself. This is really simple to do, does not require coding. That's kind of the point of these tools. You can just add these user groups. But these user groups have already been created for us. So for our needs, we are just going to drop into these to get an understanding of how the groups are created, or rather what means somebody will belong to one group or the other. So we can look at editing here. So this is the employees group. And if we drill into the conditions for the user, we see that this variable here, this field of department, is not executive. So this means that back in Google Sheets, we have a field that's called department. And if the department is not labeled to executive, then this particular user will be added to the employees group. So let's actually flip back into Google Sheets to get an understanding of this. And sure enough, here we see inside of our employee directory sheet that we have this department field, and we know that this is the name of that particular field because it is the first row in the sheet. So here is department, and we have all of these different departments labeled out here. And so we see that most of the people within this organization do not have the group of executive for their department. And so anyone who's in sales or product or marketing or engineering or any other option is going to be put in that employee group. However, we do have one person here, Pat Everett, who is the CEO of our example company. And that person, Pat, has the department of executive. So if we flip back into Softr and we look at our other group, we would expect to see in managers, if we drill in here and we look at the conditions that have been set up, that the department is executive. So this way we've said, hey, look, people are going to fit one of two different groups. They're either an executive, which makes them a manager, or they're not an executive, which makes them an employee. But I do want to point out that we could have an endless number of different groups here. We could have a group specifically for sales and marketing. That way, our sales and marketing team experiences one part of the application that we're building. And we might have another group, finance and accounting, that experiences a totally different version of the application. So we could have any number of different groups added. For our example, you either belong in one group of two. It's either employees or managers, but you, for your example, could have more groups. Now that we understand how the groups have been created, how do we actually change or cultivate the experience inside the application based on those groups? Let's take a look at what's been done in this template already. If I go into pages here and I look at the employee directory page, we're going to notice that we have this little button right here, the add record button. But let's actually click into this block and take a better look at everything that kind of surrounds this. So to understand what this button does, we have to flip into actions. This is where we can add these different buttons that give us permissions to do different things inside of our application. And here you can see that we have this button that's called add record, which is exactly what we see here. But you might notice that we've got a little bit of a condition set up here, and it's highlighted when we're not hovering over it. If we click on this, these are the permissions for this button. And we can see that the button visibility has been set so that the person must be logged in. So if you're not a logged in user, you're not going to see this button. That's a pretty good thing just in general, right? We want to make sure that people engaging with our application are actually logged in. But also, and more importantly for our example, they must belong to the manager's group. So it's only a manager, an executive of the organization, that can add new people to the directory. That kind of makes sense, right? We wouldn't want everyone in a company to be able to hire, for example. But here we have set this rule so that this button is visible to managers. Now, this does not only pertain to buttons. We can also set visibility at a block level. So if we were to come over here to visibility, we can see right now that all users are currently set to use this block. Of course, they have to be logged in users, but we could even further get into the weeds here and say, Maybe this block only pertains to managers, or maybe this block only pertains to employees. In order to get that more granular precision there, we would say only logged in users can see the block. And then that opens up the next group here, which says, well, which user groups? And we can add specific groups here. So in this way, we are able to create a unique engagement inside of our web application based on who is logged in. Now, just to verify this, let's actually take a look at this application from the perspective of both the manager and the employee. In order to do this, let's flip back into our users here, and we have the magic links, and this allows our users to just with a simple click open up our application. Now, before we can actually access our application, we of course have to publish it. So let's go ahead and do that and publish our app. And now just give it a moment here. If we were to just go to the application just by itself, this is without logging in, just copying and pasting that application, we see that we have the ability to sign in right here. So let's go back to our magic links. And I want to get the experience of this application from, let's say, Pat Everett. Now, if I recall, Pat is the executive. He is the CEO. He or she is the CEO of this organization. So by copying Pat's link and pasting this in, I'm going to get Pat's experience inside of the application. Give that just a moment to load. And we can see in the upper right corner on the little user avatar here that we are now logged in as Pat. Now, if I go to the directory, when I see this page, because Pat is a manager, then I have the ability to add a record. I can click here and I can add a new employee, provide a name, email, phone number, etc. All the information I require in order to bring somebody new on board and then send that off into the next step in the onboarding process. But notice that only Pat gets that experience. If I log out as Pat and I go back into our builder scenario here, and I can take anyone else's experience. Let's go with Tenzin here. I will copy Tenzin's magic link and paste that into a new tab. Now, when I log in, if I look again up here in the upper right corner, I'm now impersonating Tenzin. This is, if I can go into account settings here, I can see that's who I'm signed in as. If I click to the directory as Tenzin, I do not have that button. So in this way, I am able to cultivate a totally different application experience, either at a block level, at a button level, at a page level. I can use these different permissions based on the groups that I've assigned people to, and all of that is driven by the rules that I established. Now, really, the sky's the limit for you here. In this particular example, the department that was set up here inside of Google Sheets, it is what it is. But you could set up such granular rules that a phone number must begin with a certain area code, or a home address, you would require that it's in a certain state or zip code, or an email address contains a certain domain. The opportunities are really endless for you. You can get as creative as you want to determine that people fit into very specific groups, and therefore you can cultivate a very specific user experience for those different groups. Softr is an incredibly powerful tool, and I know we went pretty fast in this video, but if you have any questions that we did not address, be sure to drop them below wherever you found the video. And in the meantime, keep on building.